Spirit. May the grace and the peace of God our Father, the love of Jesus our brother, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Good morning, everyone. Today's Mass is being celebrated for the intention of Father John, whose anniversary of vows to the Society of Mary is today. We also, as a church, remember and celebrate St. Mary Magdalene. I will speak about her in the homily, but she is also known as the Apostle to the Apostles. So as we prepare ourselves now to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we first take a moment of silence to recall that we are sinners and to pray for God's mercy and forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you are the bread of life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the wine of salvation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the way, truth, and the life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. And we pause for a moment of silent prayer. God, whose only begotten Son entrusted Mary Magdalene before all others with announcing the great joy of the resurrection, grant, we pray, that through her intercession and example, we may proclaim the living Christ and come to see him reigning in your glory, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
The bride says, on my bed at night I saw him.
Gospel according to St. John. Glory to you, O Lord. On the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and she went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we do not know where they put him." Mary stayed outside the tomb weeping, and as she wept, she bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and she saw Jesus there, but she did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." And Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and then reported what he told her. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You know, I presume that most of us belong to one or two of those airline loyalty reward programs. My loyalty to Delta over the years has enabled me to fly to Europe without any cost to me a number of times. Every airline has those kind of loyalty reward programs because loyalty by a customer is highly prized for the bottom line. More loyalty, more profit. And today as a church we celebrate Mary Magdalene, and I think what really stands out about her is her loyalty to Jesus. She followed Jesus, as we know, during his public ministry, along with the other apostles. She stood with Jesus' mother Mary and John and some other women at the foot of the cross, Calvary. Mary even ventured out, as we heard in the gospel passage today, from the safety of that upper room to go to Jesus' tomb very early on the first day of the week. Now, while all of Jesus' apostles were loyal, in many ways, I think her loyalty stands out, apostle to the apostles. And we know that Mary's loyalty was rewarded because she is the first disciple to experience the risen Christ, and she is the one who brings the news to the others. Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." I would encourage each of us to find a little bit of quiet time today to think about our own loyalty to Jesus' teachings and to the mission that he gives to us and sends us on each day to love and to share and to reach out with one another. And of course, make any adjustments that we need to make in our commitment and our loyalty to Jesus. So we turn to our gracious God and we present our needs.
For our Holy Father, our bishops and priests, who are the ones privileged to speak directly to God on behalf of the people, that they may be holy enough to be summoned to the top of the mountain of divine encounter, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of peace, the fruit of listening to the voice of God and putting into practice all that he commands, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may have eyes blessed with seeing and ears blessed with hearing in the presence of our divine master Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God, who sits upon his throne above the cherubim, may look into the depths of the human need and suffering that we bring before him and grant healing and grace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have gone before us into eternity, who have seen God in the temple of his holy glory, that they may soon take their place in the company of the saints, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And from our daily prayer list, Anne Marie Cunningham, Pete Cabrelli, Mary Coffey, Paul Tomaszewski, Larry Fannin, Dick Sweeley, Billy Schroeder, and those mentioned in our prayer list and Book of Intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the cause of Jean-Claude Colon, founder of the Marists for Sainthood, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please pray for the souls of William Renaudin, father of Debbie Kehoe. May he rest in peace. Lord, hear our prayer.
And in the silence of our hearts, we add our own personal intentions. And for all of these, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together we pray for the intercession of Mary, our mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. And blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. And blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from all of my sins. Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church. Accept, O Lord, the offerings presented in commemoration of Saint Mary Magdalene, whose homage of charity was graciously accepted by your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our brother. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church faithful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love. And that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage, and their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and the saints, we too give you thanks, as in exultation we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples and so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our brother Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, Almighty Father, and said the blessing. He broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." And in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, Father, he gave you thanks, and he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this and remember me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity so that together with Francis our Pope, Gregory our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Mary Magdalene, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now have the courage to pray. Our Father, who art in as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all anxiety, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with all of you. Thank you, and we turn to each other with a gesture of peace. It's okay, there's enough. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, the Paschal Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. reception of your mysteries, Lord, instill in us that persevering love with which St. Mary Magdalene clung resolutely to Christ, her Master, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist is ended. We go forth glorifying the Lord with our lives. Thanks be to God. Have a great day, everybody.